Now let's talk about the angular velocity of connecting rod. Now, if you talk about the relations that we have done in the previous videos, we'll use one of them, which is sine phi. Okay, this is equal to sine theta upon n. The angular velocity of the crank is d theta by dt. Okay, if you remember the configuration, this is phi. Okay, so your connecting rod is oscillating with an angular displacement of phi. So the angular velocity of connecting rod would be d phi by dt. So differentiate this, you will get cos phi into d phi by dt. This is equal to cos theta upon n into d theta by dt. So basically I need to calculate this part. So it will be omega r, or you can say omega c, which is equal to d phi by dt, which is further equal to cos theta upon cos phi into this part is omega upon n. Okay, so this is practically your formula. Let's manipulate this a bit and get the value for cos phi. So from the previous analysis, we have got the value of cos phi as under root n square minus sine square theta upon n. I can put this over here, which will give me omega c d phi upon dt. This is equal to cos of theta into omega upon this n, and this n would cancel. The only value is which would be left is n square minus sine square theta. So this is the angular velocity of the connecting rod. So make a note of this. It's a very, very simple analysis. And now let's move on to the next video and talk about the angular acceleration of connecting rod.